Hello friends, I'm Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how you can send email alerts using AutoLaunch Flow in Salesforce. If you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. Here, various playlists related to Salesforce and other programming languages are available. So now I'm going to implement a flow and then that flow will be called by Process Builder. So whenever I'm going to create contact record, that Process Builder will work and it will automatically call the auto launch flow. And in auto launch flow, I'm going to use this email alert that I have already implemented. So its description unique name is written here. This email alert will work on the email field that will be available on the contact record. And this is the email template which is associated with this email alert. So you can watch my video on how to create email alert and templates that are available in Salesforce administrator playlist. So this is email template which is having this content and merge field is contact name. So I'm going to use this email alert in Lightning Flow and that flow will be called through Process Builder for execution. So now I'm going to create new flow. Flow will be auto launch flow. So I'm selecting this option. So at left hand side, you can see this action is available. So action element is for interaction. I choose that. Now from this filter by, you need to select a type and from here choose email alert. So name of our email alert is email alert to contacts. So from here, I'm going to search this. So here it is. So all available email alerts will be available here. So send email. Here you can put the description. Now we need to put the record ID. So this record ID will be related to the contact that on which we are going to pass, sorry, on which we are going to send the email. So this record ID will be provided by the Process Builder that will call this auto launch flow. So you need to check this checkbox as true that is available for input and click on done. So record ID will be provided by the Process Builder that is available in this email alert now. And I am linking this. So this way I created this auto launch flow for email alert. So send email to contacts, clicking on save, clicking on activate. So this auto launch flow is activated now. Now I'm moving to Process Builder. So here you can see one process on contact record is available. It will work when a contact record is created. Now here I need to set the criteria. So check email. So here we need to check the email field. It should not be blank. So I'm choosing email is null, false. So if email field is not null, then only we need to call the auto launch flow. So action name is call flow and here all available auto launch flows are available. So I'm going to choose send emails to contacts. And from here, I need to pass the record ID. So this record ID variable, and here you need to choose field reference and you can choose the ID of the contact record. So here it is. So contact ID will be passed to flow using this Process Builder. So I'm saving this. It is throwing an error. Not error, but so you can see it is now saved. So first it will check the email field. If it is not blank, then this action will be calling the flow and passing the record ID. Now I am activating this process. So process is activated. So now all things are linked. So first you need to create email template, then you need to create email alert, then you need to create auto launch flow with email alert action, and then you need to create a process in process builder, which will be calling the flow. Now I'm going to create a contact and let's see whether this email will be sent or not. So I refresh the page. Now I'm going to create new contact, and don't forget to fill the email ID on that contact so that email will be triggered. So I'm clicking on new. So here you need to put required field. So on contact, we have only one required field, that is last name. So I'm putting test email action using flow. And I'm also going to put the email. So email is sanjaygupta.techschool@gmail.com. And I'm clicking on save. So you can see contact record is created. Here are the details. So this is the name and this is email. Now I'm moving to my email box. Let's check whether email is triggered or not. So here you can see email is triggered successfully, and it is showing the name that is available on the record, test email action using flow, and rest of the message is plain text that is available in the email template. So here it is. So this way, I hope you understood how I created auto launch flow with email action or email alert. And then I called that auto launch flow using this process builder. Process builder is passing contact ID to the flow, and this way it is working. So here four things are available: email template, email alert, auto launch flow, and process using process builder. So this way, I hope you understood how we can send email alerts using auto launch flow with the help of process. So if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name, Sanjay Gupta, on YouTube. And here various playlists related to Salesforce and other programming languages are available. So thank you for watching this video.